Hey everybody, Scott Detweiler here. Today we're going to learn ComfyUI. This is what I consider to be the best tool out there for AI art generation at this time. It can do everything that automatic 1111 does and a lot more. So from your control nets to your LoRAs to training models, it can all happen inside of this. So Comfy actually works with us at stability.ai. So I work there as the head of quality assurance. So kind of working with this on a daily basis, and I find this to be a very powerful tool, and I want to introduce you to it. I'm going to put a link down below for you to go and install it. It's just a simple Git, and it runs on pretty much every computer that has more than 3 gig of video RAM. In fact, it'll even work on one with just CPU, although it is slow. So this is going to be the first of many videos, so you can kind of get used to the process and the workflow, and especially with SDXL about to come out, this is really the tool to use. Now, I'm sure people will have one that will run an automatic 1111, but again, you're going to see in here why we use this tool, because there's so many different things that we can apply in our workflow that we can't just do inside of one of these very easy workflows like automatic 1111. Now, there's nothing wrong with that product, and I still use it personally, but as I start to use this tool, I kind of stopped using automatic 1111, except for certain situations. And those situations now are getting to be pretty specialized, because this tool, again, can do everything. So we're going to talk about that. So here we go. Okay, let's get down to business. By the time I'm done with this, you're going to understand why we use this over automatic 1111 or Invoke or anything else out there. There is so much capability here, and it can do everything those products can do and a lot more. So let's get to it. Now, rather than walking you through some sort of grid or graph that's already done, which I don't think is very helpful, let's just start over and we'll build one from scratch, because there's a lot of little tips and tricks in here that I think that you'll love. So I'm gonna hit clear and we'll start over. So first of all, to add a node to the graph, you have a couple of different options. One, you can right click, choose add node, and we're gonna do a loader, and then we're gonna load a checkpoint. So obviously a checkpoint is your model, you know, we're used to seeing around. So we just load it that way. Now, a couple other options for adding these, and I'll show in a second, but what you want to do is just select a model that you want to work with. So we'll use one of the dreamlike photo reels from Civit, and we'll start there. All right, so now we want to do something with this. We have basically a few different processes. We need to apply prompts to it, we need to sample from that, and then we need to encode that back into an image. So we basically have three different steps that we have to do. So we have, again, what's the next step? Well, we need to get the prompts. So rather than kind of looking through this and trying to find the right thing, by the way, I may have nodes here you don't have, and there's gonna be a lot of custom nodes we're gonna add to this product over many, many videos, because there's so many of them that are very amazing. And again, they're coming out every single day. But again, we get to pick and choose which ones we wanna use. Well, rather than kind of hunting and pecking through here, we have another option. You can double click and then you can type in what you're looking for. In this case, we are going to want a case sampler. And since I used it last, it's going to be at the top here. But you could sample, you could type in sampler at the top and it would show you we have sampler and advanced case sampler, which we're going to use both in this case. So I'm going to show you one other way here, and this is the most convenient. You're going to basically click on clip and drag it out and let go. And it's going to say, what do you want to add here? Because it's paying attention. We could add a node, and which is going to take us to that, again, that menu. Or we can look through what we have in here. And sure enough, clip, text, and code is what we're looking for. Oh, there we go. Now we're gonna want two of these, one for a positive prompt and one for a negative prompt. Keep them straight. I'm gonna right click on it, choose color, and then change this one to green. This will be my positive prompt. I can also right click, go to properties, or go to title, I should say. And in here, I can put what I wanna change it to. This will be my positive prompt here. I would highly recommend you do this, because these graphs are going to get complicated quickly. And although a prompt like this sticks out, a lot of these smaller ones may get lost in the mix and you'll be trying to find where you are. And this can get weird because these graphs get gigantic if you have a complicated workflow. So now I want to duplicate this. You have, again, a couple different options. One, you can right click and choose clone. This is the way I would not recommend you do it, because that's painfully slow. You could go in and try and find it in here again, which again is painfully slow. You have the best option, which is Control C or Command C on your Mac to copy. And when we want to paste, we want to hold down the Shift key when we do our Control V or Command V. So this is Control Shift V. We'll place it back in here, but it will keep the connections outgoing and incoming in place. So this is very convenient. So this is the way I want to do this. Now I want to show you one other way, which I think is even cooler, but is not as interesting if you don't have, or it's more interesting if you have no connections, and that is simply hold on your Alt key when you click and drag and it will duplicate it quickly. So this is a very fast way if you have things that don't have to maintain connections. So there we go. Now we want to change this one, change the color of this one to red, and we're going to right click and choose title, and it'll be our negative. All right, so now we have that done. What we need to do next is we need to sample from this clip the conditioning that it's given us and start to work with the model. So we can, again, click on this and drag it out, and sure enough, case sampler is one of the options here. So I'm going to use this, and you see it's already connected to the positive force. We're going to use the negative here. We need a model. Well, we have a model right over here, so we'll drag that all the way across here. Connect it. We'll make that line as straight as we can because we are OCD. All right, so now what we need is a latent image. And a latent image is basically going to be all the noise we're going to feed into the sampler and then use the model and clip conditioning to create the image. So we want to get this the same way we've done a lot of other things. You can actually double click, or let's use the menu for once. So go add node, latent, and we go to empty latent image, and there it is. And we'll leave it as a 512 by 512, but I'm going to show you how to upscale this as well. And so we can drag this latent in here. All right, now we've got a couple of different settings in here. By the way, your mouse wheel will scroll in and out, so that's very convenient. We have a seed of 0, and you see that after this generates, it's going to randomize the seed. If you love a seed that you have, you can change it to fixed, and it won't change it again. It will update one more time, though, so just realize that you may want to copy this seed before you click again, because it may choose one more before it goes to fixed. The number of steps, let's say 20, or CFG, classifier free guidance is set to 8. The sampler we want to use is Euler here, and then we want a denoise of 1. Why do we want a denoise of 1? Well, we're taking basically a latent image here with noise in it. We want to replace 100% of that noise with the sampled versions of the condition model. Okay, now from here, we have a latent. What are we going to do with it? Well, let's find out. Let's drag it out, and we need to VAE decode. This is the last step. It's take the autoencoder, and usually your model will have an autoencoder embedded in it. If it does not, or you want to use a different one, again, you can go and there's all kinds of different things you can do. So you can load in LoRas, you can load in different types of things, but there's a load VAE. If you have a specific VAE you'd like to bring in, you can do that as well. In this case, we're just going to use the VAE from way over there and put it over here. Now, for nodes like this that don't have any numbers, like these are things I want to tweak, this doesn't have anything tweakable. To kind of minimize it, I would right-click and choose Collapse. This makes it something tiny that I really don't have to deal with, and I can even hide this in different places. All right, so we do need, however, to access the last node on it here. So before we collapse it, we'll grab the image. Now, we want to save this image as well as preview it. If we preview, that does not save it. But if we save image, that will save and preview. So just note that there's two different things. If you want to look at the steps as you're going along, then I would use preview. And again, now we can collapse this one. And some other applications actually dock their nodes next to them like this. And this is how I tend to do these graphs. If you hold in control or command and drag a rectangle and then shift click, you can move things together, which is really nice. All right, so this looks pretty good. What is it that we're looking for? Looking for a box of rocks, which tends to be my sample prompt for almost everything, and a bag of noodles, and a bag of noodles as our negative, just because I put something in there. And I always find that a negative prompt is interesting. It's kind of, think of the negative prompt as the antithesis of what you're trying to create. Rocks are not like noodles, so I don't tend to put, like, I don't know, extra hands and things. There's a whole mess of why that stuff is kind of silly. But I usually just put something, for example, these would be something soft, for example, or squishy. I would put that in here. And then hit new prompt. And you notice that it picked a random seed here. You'll notice that it is highlighting this in green. This is where it is working currently. And what's interesting about this process is that it will only start the next time we hit Q prompt at the thing that changed last. So there we go, a lovely box of rocks, just exactly what I was dreaming of. There we go. And we can make this as big as we can. And you'll notice that this is going to be the 512 by 512. So there we go. We can kind of squish that down so it's displaying it in real size here. You can also right click on this and save the image directly from here, which is nice. So if we save it, we'll throw that up there. Now let's go back and play with this a bit to kind of get a bit more advanced, because this is what you can do in automatic 1111. This is our point of departure. But we can do all kinds of crazy stuff from here. For example, let's start with the image itself. This is fine, but it's a little noisy and I'd like to make it bigger. I want to resample this. So let's do that. I'm going to control click and then shift click and move these over. And I'm going to want another sampler, but I'm going to want the advanced version of the case sampler. So we're going to add node sampling in the advanced case sampler. Why do I want the advanced one? Well, it has a bunch of other settings we're going to want to utilize here. So I need the model again. So I'm just going to grab the model. Actually, I don't need the, yeah, I do need the model. Look at my inputs, model. I need the positive prompt. I need the negative. Do you see why they label these things? It's becoming a little bit of a spaghetti fest here. And then we need a latent. Now we're not going to use the empty latent. We've already replaced the latent with the sampled version here. So we're just going to drag that here. So by the way, if you find yourself using these things all over the place, you drag one out and let go, you can actually use a reroute node. The reroute node allows you to kind of use this to do different things. So this allows you to kind of neaten up your graph a bit. If you've got a lot of things that are pulling these all the way over here, for example, then we may want to use that. All right, so what do we want to do in here? Why did we want this? Well, in here, we don't want to do 12 steps or 20 steps to start out with. Let's just do something like 12 steps because think of this like an image to image where I'm doing just 12 steps to kind of rough in what I want so that I don't get extra arms and legs or double heads or all that kind of stuff that people try and use negative prompts to fix, but isn't really a problem with negative prompts. We'll get into that another day. But in here, I want to scale this up. Well, I want to scale the latent. I don't want to scale pixels. I want to scale the latent. So let's go in here, node, and we can do, let's just double click here. We want to upscale. And we have upscale latent by. In this case, we can do it by a scale. So we're going to update. We're going to upscale this by 2. So we'll grab our samples here, drag it into here, because this is what it's just sampling from that latent. What's it want to do? It wants to shove it into this place. So we basically put this here in the middle. So we're upscaling it by 2. So this would be a 1024 and twice the size of this, 1024. But what I want to do here is, again, I have it roughed in over here because you saw this. By the way, you can do fun things like this, which I think is pretty interesting. If we take, let's take these two things and we're going to move them down here. So I'm going to put my image in here. I'm going to put my samples, which is this latent. I'm going to grab this VAE from over here. So what this is going to do is it's going to generate a preview of what we're doing here. So just 12 steps and it'll show us what that looks like. But over here, I want to start at step 12. And this is where we get that so much better than automatic 1111. I can use multiple samplers at different times in different ways. So here, for example, my scheduler is set to normal. This is what you would normally start out with. But now I want to try and get as far into the step process as possible. So I would change this to something like exponential or Keras. Keras, by the way, Euler, if you don't know who he is, he's a German mathematician, lived like, I think, the 1500s. Brilliant man, still use a lot of his stuff today, obviously, in science. And then Keras is actually a scientist who works at NVIDIA. So a lot of those things are because of his brain. So it's very cool of him to be someone that is inventing a lot of cool math as we're doing this stuff. All right, so from here, what I want to do is I want to take and start at step 12, and I want to go to, say, maybe step 30. This, and we'll use the Keras scheduler to try and move faster than the normal one. And there we go. So we'll hook this latent. Now, we can't hook it into this because I collapsed it. So I want to right-click, uncollapse it, like this. So it's going from here to here, 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 finally here. Okay, so let's try this prompt. And you notice that it started here because this is where it changed the seed. And then it doesn't go all the way back to reload the model every time. So this could be a lot faster. Okay. And you'll find what we do is we would move these next to each other so we can compare them. So you see what we started out with in the quick rough sketch of steps. And then we obviously improved upon that down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to borrow this number just to make sure I keep it the same. One other cool trick, by the way, if you notice, we have two different seeds here. And although that's cool in this situation, what if I don't want them to be different and I don't want to sit and copy and paste seeds? One other cool thing you can do is you can turn certain values into inputs. So again, if you right click on something, you see down here, it has all these. We can do convert noise seed to input. And you notice that noise is now gone and it's here. We can do the same to this one. So we can do convert noise seed, convert seed to input. There we go. What I want to do is I want a what's called a primitive. So I can right click, add node. If you go down to utilities, now I have utilities you probably won't have, but that's fine. You'll see primitive is always here. And there we go. So when you connect it to something, it's going to figure out what it needs to do. Oh, it needs an integer. There we go. And I can dictate whether it's fixed. I can say randomize and so on, just like we could down there. In this case, I'm going to replace this with the number that I liked. And then again, grab this integer and drag it down here. So now we have one place where we can change the seed for everything we work on. If this is going to be randomized, by the way, and I don't want to look at it anymore, again, I would just collapse it because we don't need to fiddle with it constantly. Same with this one. I tend not to collapse a lot of these, but if I'm just trying to get them out of my way, I'll collapse them and stack them and do all kinds of crazy things. And you do what you want to do to minimize your wires driving you nuts, but it's just an OCD exercise. So we'll click prompt, do it again. This time it's going to use the primitive. So the seeds are the same in both noises. Not that that matters, because you can use different seeds. Obviously we did it and it worked fine. Now we could do this again and again, creating different steps and sampling the data in different ways in order to get the images that we like. I think this is so incredibly powerful. So this is your introduction to Comfy. So take a look at it, install it. I'm not going to do the installation. You just go to the Git and download it. It's that simple. It works on pretty much every PC, even an old M1 Mac, where automatic 1111 tends not to work on some of those older ones. No, it will be slow. You can also put it in CPU only mode. If it doesn't detect a GPU, it will go into CPU only mode for you. So it's a lot smarter. I like the fact that Comfy actually works with us at Stability Now. So if you didn't know this, you can actually drag any image that's been created in Comfy directly into the graph and it will load it for you, including the seeds. So it's a really powerful way to load work from previous images you've been working on to continue going forward. When, by the way, we talk about the queue, we didn't talk about queuing the prompt very much, but if you just go up here, you can hit queue, by the way, and you can just queue a bunch of these. So if you want this to run a whole bunch of these things. Now note that I'm not saving these images. They're only previewing. In order to save them, we would actually use a save node, which I did not do. But now you know how to do that yourself. So anytime you want to save it, you would just go ahead and either click on it here and hit save, or again, I would use the save node. And again, if you can't find it, you can always just drag it out from one of these other things, like in the decode here, drag it out, and you'll see that it'll have save image here if you don't want to try and find it in that menu. So let me know what you think in the comments below. If you have questions or comments, we will do a few more videos on this because we're going to do a whole bunch of different stuff. But I thought this was a pretty good introduction as to the workflow, so you understand the basics of how to use it. You can sit and OCD around your graphs and get your noodles to be all the way you want them to be, and kind of come up with your own little workflow. And as new models come out, you just change the model over here and the workflow will all fit. So there you go. Everybody, thanks for hanging around with me today. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Getting back to making more videos again. Obviously, I've been very busy with the release of different models and doing different QA operations, and I want to keep you up to date with things. I'm also thinking about starting a podcast because obviously I get to know a lot of information that I want to pass on, news and information. I think that might be pretty interesting. So I'm going to get the whole membership thing back up again. I appreciate the people so much who stuck through this whole time when I wasn't really making many videos, although I did get a lot of questions from them and I was trying to be as interactive as possible. So we're going to get that right back up. And those people that have stuck around all this time, I'm going to make it up to you. We're going to get a whole bunch of stuff going inside of there. And a lot of these images that I generate inside of Comfy, again, you can drag those right into the graph and it'll load it. I'm going to start to kind of make that a thing that I'm going to do as well. So I'm going to create some pieces of art that I really love, drag them out there, and then let the patrons load those in, or not patrons, but my YouTube members. So everybody, thanks again, and I'll talk to you later. Everybody take care, stay safe, and I'll catch you next time.